Now, let's try to solve previous question. As we did with change in curved surface area, we can calculate percentage change in volume as well. We know, of course, that the volume of the cylinder is... What happened with there? Okay, no problem. We will have the chapter on mensuration later. For now, you may just note that the volume of a cylinder is pi r square h. This can be written as pi into r into r into h. And according to question, there is an increase of 20%. Then an increase of 20%, and then a decrease of 15%. So we can say, Vidya, that there are three successive changes. The first, increase of 20%, we can call RA. The next, increase of 20% again, we can call it RB. And the decrease of 15%, we can call RC. Therefore, for calculating percentage change in volume, first we have to club RA and RB, which can be written as 20 plus 20 plus 20 into 20 by 100 equal to 44%, which we can call RD. Now club RD and RC to get the final percentage change in volume, which is equal to 44 minus 15 minus 44 into 15 divided by 100, which is equal to 29 minus 6.6, that is 22.4%. And yes, Vidya, it is positive, showing that there has been an overall increase in volume by 22.4%. Now, let me ask you a question, Vidya, to check your memory. Are you ready?
Yes.
So tell me, what would be the percentage change in total surface area?
Total surface area is equal to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square and plus and not multiply.
Well, Vidya, I have told you before, if there is a sign of multiplication, we will consider it as successive change. But if there is a sign of addition,
then it is not considered as successive change.
Right. Good. So we can't calculate percentage change in total surface area with the given information. You have to remember these crucial points, Vidya.